This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to calculate the present value of an annuity using a TI-83 or TI-84 calculator. So here's the problem we're going to work with. It says, what is the present value of an annuity paying $100 per month for the next 8 years if the money is compounded monthly at 4.5%. So here's what this means. We want to know how much money you would have to deposit into an account that paid 4.5% compounded monthly so that you would be able to take out $100 every month for the next 8 years. We have a formula for doing it. It's the present value formula. The formula says that the present value, this is the amount of money you would be depositing, is equal to the payment, that's how much money you're going to take out every month, multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus I, and I is the rate per period as a decimal. In other words, we're going to take the annual interest rate, turn it into a decimal, and divide that by the number of periods per year to find the rate per period. We're going to take that whole thing, raise it to the negative n power. N is the total number of periods altogether. So in our case, it's 12 periods per year times 8 years, or 96 periods. That whole thing is going to get divided by I, which once again was the rate per period as a decimal. Okay, so we can do this with the calculator. The biggest problem in doing it with a calculator is that there are a lot of places to make mistakes. So we're going to do it step by step and try to avoid parentheses wherever we can. The first thing I'm going to do is figure out what this I in the parentheses, in the numerator of the fraction should be. So I is the rate per period as a decimal. To find the rate per period, we want to take the rate per year as a decimal. That's 0.045. And divide that by the number of periods per year, and it's going to be 12. Okay, so now we've got the rate, we've got the I, the rate per period. We want 1 plus I, so I'll take that answer and add a 1 to it. Now that we've got 1 plus I, we want to raise that to the negative n power. So I'll use the raise to button. That's here on the right side underneath the clear button. Let's get the negative in before we forget it. So we're going to raise the answer to negative n. And n is the total number of periods. Well, there's 12 periods per year times 8 years. So that would be 96. So we have the answer raised to the negative 96. And we get 0.698, and then this number keeps going. Okay, we want that decimal. We want to take 1 minus that decimal, 0.698. So I'm going to press 1 minus, and what I'm looking for is actually 1 minus the previous answer. So to get the previous answer, I press second, and then right next to the enter button is the negative sign. And above that little negative sign, it says answer. So now we have 1 minus the previous answer. That's 0.3018. And that's the numerator for this fraction. I want to take that numerator and divide it by I. So I'm going to divide by, and I'll need parentheses here, because I'm dividing by a fraction. Once again, I is the rate per period. So that's 0.045, the rate per year, divided by the number of periods, which was 12, and we get 80.49. Now, that's this big fraction. We want to take that fraction and multiply it by the payment that we expect to get. We want to get $100 per month. So I'm going to take that 80.49 and multiply it by 100. and I get $8,049.43. So what this is saying is that if I deposit $8,049.43 into an account which pays 4.5% compounded monthly, then every month I can take out $100, and I can do that for the next 8 years. Okay? That's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.